that's sort of how to do sampling efficiently. The other thing is, how often do you have to resample? Well, in the algorithm that I showed you, we resample all the time, and that's so that we have a whole bunch of samples that are about uniform weight and we spread them out. If I don't have too many samples that have very large weights, maybe I don't have to resample. Maybe I can just reuse the weights, the same samples over again, right? I still have to apply the deterministic part and I have to apply the expansion part, but I don't have to do that resampling. And you can do that by just saying, let me take a look at sort of the variation in the weights. I want them as uniform as possible. And as long as they have a certain amount of uniformity to them, I won't resample. So that reduces the number of times you do resampling. A second problem is, what if P of Z given X, what if your likelihood is incredibly peaked? Remember, you multiply the likelihood times the weights of the samples. If it's incredibly peaked, that means that P of Z given X is zero almost everywhere else. That's not very helpful, because what that means is you've wiped out all of your possible predictions. In general, you want to allow for noise in your P of Z given X. Don't be so systematic about it. And you also might want to be better at sort of how you do your proposals to begin with, right? So you want to make sure that your particle filter sort of spreads out the points to begin with. And one way of doing that actually is, if you think of a sample, each sample you can think of as having its own little mini Kalman filter. So you can think of it as having a Gaussian that sort of spreads itself out and goes forward. In general, you're much better off overestimating noise and let your measurements sort of narrow you down than underestimating noise and have your measurements think that they're much more accurate than they are, or I should say much more constraining than they are. Another issue is recovery from failure. Suppose an object really did disappear and reappear. If I have no particles there, I don't have any way of tracking it ever. So a standard thing to do is, each iteration, you randomly put out some particles everywhere or sort of uniformly distributed. Because if my measurements suddenly have moved over here, there'll be some particles over there, and eventually that will be the distribution that will be tracked. So those three issues of sort of making sure you're smart and efficient about your resampling, not letting your system think that measurements are too precise, and making sure you have enough noise so that you don't kill off samples too quickly, and this idea of having some random samples distributed in a useful way so you can track things if things change very unexpectedly, all these things are necessary to make particle filtering work.